Another start to another week. We're here at the shipper where we have to drop our trailer and give them the keys to get loaded. And for good reason, because they have a picture right there by the window where you check in, where somebody had pulled out on a forklift operator, broke his ankle. He's all right, other than breaking his ankle. But it's situations like that that can be avoided if people just pay attention. You're not supposed to even touch your trailer until you have the paperwork in hand. So I don't know how it happened. It's usually pretty strict about that here. Anyways, we've got a short load going up to Olathe, Kansas. So I'll probably get up to the Sapp Brothers there in Harrisonville and spend the night there and then do the rest in the morning, because there's really no other parking. And I know that there's no parking at this particular customer. We'll get on there in the morning. It's not too early. And look for our next load. So I'm not going to book anything ahead, because the customer that I'm going to potentially can take a little bit. So we don't want to screw anything up. I will look for some first come first serve type loads, but my faith in that is pretty low. Hopefully they'll get us loaded here pretty quickly, and then we'll head on down the road. I'm here at the Sapp Brothers in Harrisonville, Missouri. Got my Dunkin' Donuts coffee, and we're gonna get rolling. Says if I leave right now, I'll get there right at 7. My appointment's at 8. I still gotta do my pre-trip yet. So we'll get that going and get on out of here. Well, it took about 4 hours to unload here in Olathe. I went to this little mom and pop 7-Eleven, something like that, built 66. It's a little truck stop. Sat here for about 5 minutes, booked my next load. I'm deadheading out of here to Brookfield, Missouri, and it goes to Nixon, Missouri, and delivers tomorrow morning. So it's an open window till 6 today, which is what I needed with my unlimited hours. And then we're only 4 hours to a customer for tomorrow. I've got about 8 hours left. Quickly, and then I can do most, if not all, the trip today. So we'll see what happens.
In 600 feet, turn left onto South Caldwell Street.
Quickly, and time's kind of tight now, so we're going to try to get shut down in Elder, Missouri. Let's see if we can make it. We are here in Elder, Missouri. I was hoping to get to Lebanon, or even better, Conway. Didn't happen. Got in a traffic jam there outside of Columbia. That kind of, there's no reason to really risk going over my hours. So, but this is a good truck stop. Here's the view. Gotta be careful, there's no curbs here. You don't want to accidentally back there. I'm sure it's happened. So yeah. There's a good restaurant next door. I'll show you the parking lot.
parking lot. There's a restaurant over there. Scale over there. I used to scale loads a lot here. I used to pick up loads for Schneider out in Jefferson City, and I'd scale them here. We're gonna go in the truck here and work on some of my computer stuff. Tomorrow's delivery is at 9 a.m. I don't have anything booked yet after that, so we'll see what happens. We're gonna leave tomorrow, about 2 hours away from Nixa. Probably gonna leave here about 5:30 to beat the lake traffic through Lake of the Ozarks and stop and go traffic in Lebanon, Missouri. And then the stop and go traffic that'll be in Springfield to get to Nixa. Should be a pretty decent day tomorrow. Hopefully I'll find something. The only problem is I'll be starting my clock early. So that's kind of what happened today, is I started my clock early today, so it kind of limited on my time. We'll see what tomorrow brings. Rates are going up. Everybody's killing it here, like trucking. So, we shall see. Got here, as you can see, you know, doesn't look too bad. I was looking at Google Maps or Google Street View, and there was a Walmart truck that was in here one time, the time the picture was taken. And it was funny, there's somebody flashing a shirt. I might try to find that picture and post it on Facebook. But you know, they got these middle docks, and they claim that the product is too high to go through those doors, which looks like a standard door size to me. And then they proceed to warn me that these guys hate truck drivers, and they don't, you know, because it would have been easy just to pull in and pull out, right? But apparently rumor has that these guys hate truck drivers and they don't want them doing that, hence the reason for the barriers. So the biggest challenge for me was not getting the front wheels and that. So got into a little bit, but not like deep where it could have ruined the fairing. So we're checking the fairings out. I think we're good. But then I have these walls on each side. It was not a fun back. It took about 15 minutes. You know, and basically half of that was just kind of taking a deep breath, because it wasn't, you know, that's the thing. You get frustrated and you curse and you beat the steering wheel, but you don't. You gotta take 10. You gotta take 10. And that's what I did, and got her in there. So, anyways, that's what it looks like on that side. But we did our check calls to the broker, and don't have anything booked yet. I should be doing that instead of talking to this GoPro, but figured I'd show the challenges that I had to face. Now, back on those docks would have been easy. You know, you could blindside into those, but oh well, no biggie. So when I leave here, I gotta worry about my tail swing on those walls. But alrighty, so let's go take care of business. It's been a fun day. As you can see, looks like it's been raining again. Here at the Vandalia, Illinois. And we're on our way to North Canton, Ohio.
So we picked up our load in Springfield. And we drove, let's see, it was 860 miles. No. 760 miles to here, North Canton, Ohio, and I picked up in Navarre. Now my appointment time was supposed to be 9 a.m. in Navarre, but the broker assured me that I could go at any time. This customer I've been to before with the Big Orange, but I've never live loaded there, so we'll see how that goes. This is taking a little bit longer than I thought it would. This unload here at this place in North Canton. But them's the brakes. We should still be good on the delivery for the next load. We'll see what happens. Saturday's delivery went well. And I booked another load, picking up Saturday morning, delivered Sunday morning in Olney, Illinois. It was a little bit tight, but I knew I could get it done if they loaded me in a good amount of time. Unfortunately, they didn't. I was informed that they were waiting on product. I got out of there a little bit later than I anticipated. So we're having to do the 8-2 sleeper berth split to make this run work on time. So I've got about 15 minutes before I can roll. It's 3 a.m. my time that I can roll. So it's about 2:45. Got fuel at this Love's last night after going through a hellacious thunderstorm. And again, you know, just like the hill video. And got parked, got a shower, cooked dinner, watched Pale Rider TV's live feed, then I went to bed. And we're up here early in the morning. And I don't have anything booked after this, so what my clock does after that doesn't matter. There's a truck stop nearby in Olney. We'll see if my signal's good so I get on the low boards from there. If not, I'll just drive up to Effingham. But Olney puts me in a good spot for several different markets. You got Effingham, St. Louis, Indianapolis, Evansville, Indiana. It's a good central location. So Monday morning, we should be able to find whatever we want. So that's my day. It's going to be an early day, but a short day. There's nothing on Uber or Convoy right now, so probably be sitting for most of the day. That'll give me a chance to catch up with paperwork and my receipts and everything. And all the owner-operator stuff involved, getting all put in my computer and all that. So hopefully the e-log does what it's supposed to here at 3:01 a.m. To my area with my hours kind of coming down. And so I got to about Effingham, and get a call from the broker that it's been canceled. They gave me a truckload or not use. So I gave Jeff a call to inform him what was going on. Then he's like, hey, here's an Uber load. So another Uber load. Picking up in Terre Haute. Unfortunately, I went right instead of left when I got to Effingham, because if you would have called me 5 minutes sooner, I could have gone south to the truck stop. Instead, I went north. And it's 10 miles to the next exit to turn around. I could cut through the woods, but I think it's just quicker just to go back to I-70 from 57. So we got an open window on that, and an open window on delivery tomorrow in Columbia, Missouri. And we'll head on down, see how this goes. This will be my first live load and unload for this particular customer. So we'll see how that goes. And so that's our Monday adventure so far. We made it here to Kingdom City. I picked up a load in Terre Haute, Indiana. And it's a load of cinder blocks. The way they load cinder blocks is center down the trailer. I put two straps on the end. But you got to be real careful, because if you hit a curb or take the turns too sharp, those bricks could collapse and they'll be all over the place. Not to mention it could, you know, cause other stuff. So we're being really careful with this load. We've got 23 miles to go. It's going to a store. So I was using the Google Maps to kind of see an overview of how I need to get into the store. And it looks fairly easy, but we'll see. There might be an awning that I got to worry about, but since I've never been in this store, I don't know. So we'll deliver that. We don't have another load booked yet. Get ready to do my pre-trip. And by the time I get there, it'll be time to look to see what's going on with the load boards. We've got 16 hours left of our 70, and then I start gaining tomorrow or in the morning. You know, 4, 8, 10, you know, I wrote them all down. But pretty nice day out. Where I parked, I'm here at Gaspers, I think is what they call it. There's no one around me. I improvised parked. There was three trucks over here, and they've gone, so I'm the only one left. But we'll get on down the road and make this delivery, and then that will end our 7-day streak. So if you've watched this far, thank you. I appreciate it. It's been a good week, good revenue. Probably the best I've done yet. So I keep getting better, and the rates keep getting better. You know, a month ago, the average rates were at $215 for dry van. Now they're at $230 as of the post I saw today on Facebook. Or, well, it's actually a link to a blog that the DAT board puts out. So rates are definitely up. But anyways, thanks for watching, and be safe out there. See ya.